The ring canvas was very soft. There was an inch and a half foam on the ring for Chavez, who likes to walk forward. It didn't allow me to get up on my toes, which is my best attribute. But you know, I got up, I showed courage. A win's a win, and here's Scott Quigg one as well. So that's a good win for him, a very good win for him. And it swings again now, where people were thinking probably Frampton wins. Now they're thinking probably Quigg wins. But that's boxing.
That tees it all out.
It sets it up for a massive fight. But I need to sit down with my team and reevaluate where I go from here. I had a lot of weight to take off the day of the weigh-in. Too much, more than ever. Just maybe done it wrong. I don't know.
It's not so much doing it wrong. I just think it's his body. You know, he's 28. He's full of muscle. There's not an ounce of body fat on him. You know, he's huge for weight. We just reevaluate how much, you know, what we can take out, and then you know, maybe move up to featherweight, or even, you know, we're out of our comfort zone here. You know, we're away from home, so the stuff that we would normally do, you know, is different over here. So it's just, you know, a couple of lessons learned. But I thought, you know, he stuck to his guns, came out with a win. You know, showed some serious courage to get through that, and showed some serious focus. And if you look at the knockdowns, they were flash knockdowns. So that's a sign of somebody that's still aware, but he's, you know, he's getting flash knocked down because he's obviously, something's going wrong with the weight. So, you know, that's where we reevaluate and then take it from there.
Or very quickly, a message for the fans at home.
I don't know, I feel like I want to say sorry. it wasn't an amazing performance, but, you know, a win's a win, onwards and upwards. I'll be back to Belfast, back in the Odyssey Arena, and no one's going to beat there.
And still the world champion.
Thank you. Were you
after those first two knockouts?
I was shocked. I was very shocked, but they were flies. You know, I had my wits about me straight away. But surprised at Alejandro's skill level. He's great hard hit clean. He could take a very good shot. Very good fighter.
What did your trainer tell you in the corner right after that round?
He told me to relax. He told me to relax and just, you know, keep my wits about me. I was recovered. You know, he could tell. Me and Shane know each other like the back of our hands, and he could tell that it was okay. But I just needed to just stick the game plan, win the rounds, and that's what I've done.
Thanks, guys.
Alejandro's got a good lean back. You know, if you look at him, he's very long, got good long leverages. So when Carl was, he was leaning in, he was falling short with his shots, and every time he fell short with the right hand, he came square on. That's when he was getting hit with the left hook, which is his best shot. So that's, you know, what our thing was, to double the jab up, throw the right hand, and finish every combination on the jab or a left hook, and it brings you back around onto the back foot. But that's exactly what he did as the fight went on, and he, as you said, started to get into his rhythm and start picking the rounds off, and that's the sign of a champion.
Thanks, guys.
Shane, dangerous, yeah. Scary moment, but he came through, prevailed, and he did great.
Yeah, you know, that's the thing. It's just, you know, this is what champions are made of, and, you know, Carl's a phenomenal fighter. I see him day in and day out of the gym, and you know, it was a surprise for me because I've never seen him hurt like that.
But that for me but he was, came back and
that,
he won.
That for me was just showing that there was, you know, he was still focused, because most people, when they get dropped like that or hurt, then they come back and they're a bit groggy. He was clear as a whistle, so I knew it wasn't the shots that were hurting him. I knew it was something else. It was just the fact that the ring canvas was extremely thick, and he wasn't able to step back, and he was just getting nailed in punching distance, and there was a little bit too much weight to be cut.
So who do you want him to fight next?
To be honest, I think Scott Quigg's a massive fight. He's just knocked out Kike Martinez. Surprising, but I thought, you know, that was going to be the outcome of the fight. And I think, you know, it just hypes up the fight even more. People will probably sway more towards Quigg now. But I know that he's got Quigg's number. And
like Broner says, easy work.
Easy work. I know, boxing's never easy work.
No, I'm joking. But yeah, you know, but he should win. Carl should win that one.
I think he's got that. I think he'll win that fight. And then, you know, obviously we'll take a look at the winner of Abner Mares versus Leo Santa Cruz, because that's a huge fight.
He reminded me a lot of Santa Cruz, Gonzalez.
Yeah,
same style, same body shape.
He's a harder puncher than Santa Cruz. He doesn't throw as many punches, but punch for punch, he's a way harder puncher. And
lengthy.
Yeah,
reach.
I want to go and see what's in the bloody reps.
How much of the two knockdowns do you think were because of the nerves coming in the United States for the first time?
Do you know what it was? It was, you know, there's not a lot of footage on this guy, you know, so we were expecting him to be a bit, you know, as he was very negative. He was moving back, trying to walk him on the shots, and you know, he doesn't look like he's that hard of a puncher. But I think Carl was saying, you know, he's a hard puncher, but at the same time, he didn't feel himself. You know, the ring canvas was heavy. He normally steps back rather than leans back, and he's a short man for super bantamweight. So when he was leaning back, he was still in punching range with Gonzalez's long levers. So, you know, it's just, you know, the best thing about it is, you know, he stuck to his game plan and he changed. You know, we went from plan A to plan B, and that plan B prevailed, and, you know, he showed the heart of the line.
Who do you see the winner of that Santa Cruz Mares fight?
I thought it was going to be Mares, but, you know, you can never tell in boxing. It could go either way, so we'll keep our eyes open for either one.
Overall, how would you grade his performance, his debut here in the United States?
Courage, 10. Boxing skill, 5. And overall performance, maybe a 7. Yeah, 6 or 7.
Well, congratulations. You guys retained that title.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
All right, there you have it. Thanks so much. Come back soon. FaceReport.com. Melissa, back reporting. So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Eli Sekpak, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Eli Sekpak.